everybody, and a very happy St. Patrick's Day to you all. And to all our Irish cousins, wherever they may be. I'm very privileged to be able to play a handmade Irish guitar this evening. First time I've done it on St. Patrick's Day. The first song for me, anyway, is one we all know, and please join in the chorus. It's Molly Mullum. Dublin's fair city, where the girls are so pretty, I first set my eyes on sweet Molly Mullum. As she reeled the wheelbarrow through streets broad and narrow, frying cockles and mussels, singing. The tradition is not dying in South Wales. This next song is a song I'm in Blackwood Miners Institute singing. Remember, we used to have mines a long time ago. We had communities where institutes like this were an integral part. A friend of mine, a great Welsh singer-songwriter called Phil Millerchip from Cumbran, wrote a song. He was a part time in his life he was a district nurse, and one of his patients was a retired miner who was very, very seriously ill, and Phil went to treat the man on a regular basis, and in conversations they had, the gentleman said, "Phil, if I had a son, he would never go down there." So Phil took, being the wordsmith that he is, took that line and wrote this song. It's called "If I Had a Son." When I was a boy, I was ready and willing to act like a man. Work for me pay, so I went underground when the hooter did sound, and I worked all me best years away, and I've seen men go down there and never come back, and I've seen men who lived and wished they were dead, but the choice is you eat or grow hungry. You see that your children are fed, and if I had a son, he would never go home. call, making tours every bit, from Bedwas to China. They've broken me body and soul. Search of the dirty black hole. I remember a man, he was trapped in the sea, with 2 ton of coal on his head. As I lay in the dark, to the beat of me heart, I still hear the words that I said. If I ever get out of this hellhole I'm in, I'll never come back here again. Tell me, what could I do? Tell me, where could I go? So I put on these pit boots again. And if I had a son, he would never go down there to work all his days in a damp, dingy hole. They can close every pit from Bedwas to China. They've broken me body and soul in search of the dirty black hole. As I walk all the mountains, the memories there still, though they've covered the scars on the land. With the grass that grows over the dirty black slag heaps, and nature has given a hand, but they can't put new breath in my body, nor heal all the scars that they find. I'll bring back my friends who are dead and long gone. I'll lay them to rest in my mind. And if I had a son, he would never go down there to work all his days in a damp, dingy hole. They can close every pit from Bedwas to China. They've broken me body and soul. I take all the tablets that the doctors prescribe, and I rest while I'm climbing the stairs. And I curse every day of my youth thrown away, and I wonder if anyone cares. When I look at the child in the faded old photo and see what's become of the man, I remember the dream that was crushed in the sea, digging coal from the bowels of the land. And if I had a son, he would never go down there to work all his days in a damp, dingy hole. They can close every pit from Bedwas to China. They've broken me body and soul. You were great guinea pigs. I haven't sung that one out before. You were wonderful guinea pigs. Right. I'm trying to go around the British Isles tonight with some songs. A couple of the songs I sing, I actually know the people that wrote them. But this one, we're off to Scotland. Another one with a chorus. The heat affects these things. It's all right for these pianist people and these bassoon players. Generally blow it clear, but this is called Annie McKelvey. The story in this is about a chap who asks a girl if she wants to come to the dance with him. And of course, being a female, she has to think about it and do her hair and ask her mother. That was the main one. And as all you boys in the audience know, she didn't turn up, did she? Dumbarton's the place I met Annie McKelvey, walking along the Clyde shore. We chatted for hours as the evening was falling, then I walked her back home to her door. I said, "You fancy a night at the dancing with me? The band at the town hall's the finest you'll see, and if there's not another place you'd rather be, then come to the dance with me, Annie." She said, "I need a few days to think o'er your proposal. Mother wouldn't need to consent." So we parted that night with a kiss on the doorstep. Back home through bowling I went. I said, "You fancy a night at the dancing with me? The band at the town hall's the finest you'll see, and if there's not another place you'd rather be, then come to dance with me, Annie." That she'd come to the dancing, she travelled from Clydebank by train. On that cold station platform I waited for hours, but I never saw Annie again. I said, "You fancy a night at the dancing with me? The band at the town hall's the finest you'll see, and if there's not another place you'd rather be, then come to the dance with me, Annie." Well, it's oftentimes I walk by the banks of the Leven, follow its flow to the Clyde, and it's there that I think about Annie McKelvey, the lassie who wounded my pride. I said, "You fancy a night at the dancing with me? The band at the town hall's the finest you'll see, and if there's not another place you'd rather be, then come to the dance with me, Annie." Try it with me. "Do you fancy a night at the dancing with me? Band at the town hall's the finest you'll see, and if there's..."